on today's visits.
Well, Tiffany, with the primary schedule in some disarray, candidates know it's possible they could have just a couple months left before things get really crazy. So renewed attention is now focused here in New Hampshire.
In his bid for the White House, Mitt Romney has a powerful new ally. The former Massachusetts governor made a three-stop tour through the Granite State Monday with former U.S. Senator Judd Gregg.
Well, Kathy and I just think he's by far the best candidate for our party. We think he speaks about what's important for us today, which is that we have to have a leader who understands how prosperity and our future in this country can be energized.
Romney is feeling the heat of yet another fresh challenge to his frontrunner status, this time from Herman Cain. Asked by one questioner to contrast his private sector success with that of Cain's, Romney said it might be experience in government that sets him apart.
And that's probably something that, if I were Herman, I'd say I wish I had that too. Because you don't want to necessarily learn that for the first time as the President of the United States.
Michelle Bachmann returned to New Hampshire for the first time since June, blaming her long absence on D.C. politics.
Well, I think what people need to understand is that I was busy all summer going back and forth to Washington, D.C. to fight against raising the debt ceiling. That's what the problem was.
At Southern New Hampshire University, John Huntsman made a major foreign policy speech, once again staking out moderate Republican ground.
I've been deeply involved three times as an ambassador for my country. So I think we are in a much different place than any of the other candidates who might talk foreign policy, if they have anything to say at all.
And in Concord, Rick Santorum spoke at the Christian Academy, saying the current game of primary leapfrog is hurting the process.
This kind of chaos is not good. It only helps Obama, and it may help a campaign, but it's not going to allow the voters to really have the opportunity to focus and make, I think, a good decision.
Now, the line of the night didn't come from a politician. At Romney's Hopkinton Town Hall, one older gentleman brought up the Red Sox recent demise and drew big laughs when he said it was evidence that you can't solve a problem just by throwing money at it. Adam Sexton, WMUR News 9.